In this video, we're using conservation of energy to solve what I would call a rotational Atwood machine. So the setup here is that we have a heavy disk of mass big M and radius big R, and this is mounted to a little hub of radius little r beneath it. There's string wrapped around that little hub and run over a light pulley to a hanging mass with a mass of little m. And we're going to release this system from rest and allow that little m to fall through a distance of d. And then what we're trying to find in the problem is the final angular velocity of that heavy disk and also the final speed of that hanging mass little m that's falling downward. So one of the most common mistakes in the setup of this problem is forgetting that that hanging mass has some kinetic energy. So we go ahead and pop that final speed for the hanging mass into the diagram, and that means it has some kinetic energy. So to get into part A of the problem, where we're trying to find the final angular speed of the disk, we're going to start from the beginning by stating energy conservation, E initial is equal to E final. And in my initial state, everything is stationary. We're starting out from rest here, so there are no kinetic energy terms. And what I can do in terms of potential energy is I can put the origin of my y coordinate at the lowest point of the problem. So that's where the hanging mass is in the final state. And that means the initial gravitational potential energy of this hanging mass is just m times g times d. So our initial energy is very simple. It's just m times g times d. It's just that one potential energy term. Now in the final state, I don't have any gravitational potential energy because my hanging mass is now at the zero of the y coordinate, but I do have two kinetic energy terms. The first of those is 1/2 I omega squared for the disk, and the second is 1/2 mv squared for the hanging mass. So in the next line, we'll plug in a couple details here. First, I want to express the moment of inertia of the disk in terms of its mass and radius, and that turns out to be 1/2 mr squared. And I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. Next, we want to relate the linear speed of this hanging mass to the rotational speed of the disk. And so the whole trick here is to realize that if our mass is moving with a speed of v, then the string itself is moving with a speed of v. And that means the string is moving with a speed of v even right there at the edge of that little hub underneath our disk. And because the string isn't slipping against the hub, it means the tangential speed at the edge of the hub is the same v. And we have a nice formula relating the tangential speed at the edge of a rotating disk to the angular velocity. And that's just v equals r omega. So it's critically important there that you use the little r, that's the radius of the hub the string is actually wrapped around. And now we've got both of our kinetic energy terms in terms of omega. So we'll clean things up a little as we get ready to solve for omega here. And the first thing I'm going to do is multiply both sides by 4. So I end up with 4 mgd on the left. And then on the right side, I'll go ahead and factor out an omega squared. And multiplying by 4 gets rid of both of these fractions in the kinetic energy of the disk term. And I end up with just an mr squared in there. And multiplying by 4 leaves me with a net factor of 2 on the translational kinetic energy term. So I end up with a plus 2 m little r squared. Finally, to solve for omega, we just have to divide by this term in parentheses and then take the square root. And so we end up with this big expression for the final angular velocity of the disk. That's 4 little mgd divided by big m big r squared. Those are the dimensions of the disk, plus 2 little m little r squared, where little m is the mass of the hanging mass and little r is the radius of the hub that the string was wrapped around. And then we square root that entire fraction. So the follow-up question here really isn't that big of a deal. I mostly put that into the question just as a reminder so students wouldn't forget the kinetic energy of the hanging mass actually matters. So to get the final speed of the hanging mass, we're just back to using that idea that v equals r omega. Again, that's telling us the speed on the edge of a disk of radius little r that's rotating with an angular velocity of omega, but that's the same as the speed of the string, and that's the same as the speed of the hanging mass. So this v is just r times omega, but we just solved for omega. So all we have to do is take our previous answer and multiply it by little r. So there's our expression for the speed of the hanging mass, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.